Students of BLDAV Shalimar Bagh, here me Diksha, and this is Divya. Going to prepare our dish, that is
Chilke ki sabzi of ghiya and tori, that is bottle gourd and rich gourd. So let's get started.
And along with it, we will be preparing wheat bran roti.
First, we are going to take a non-stick pan. We are going to add 1 tablespoon of oil. We are going to add 1/2 tablespoon of cumin seed. When it starts to crackle, add 25 grams of chopped onions and saute it till light brown.
Till the time it is being sauteed, we shall prepare our roti dough for the roti. Now we will take a veggie and take about 50 grams of wheat bran. We will take 25 grams of atta, some bread crumbs, and we will finally grate the cauliflower's leaflets and add them to the mixture. To add some spice, we will add some green chilies. Salt according to taste and some ajwain. Now we will knead the dough with the help of some water. To minimize the time and to make it rest, I have already prepared the dough.
Then we are going to take the peel of tori like this. And then we are going to add 25 grams of chopped tomatoes, 5 grams of chopped garlic and ginger, and chopped tori. And chopped ghee peas.
Tori pieces also to add to increase its flavor.
Add salt to taste, 1/2 tablespoon of turmeric powder
and some hing oil.
Chopped green chilies. Add some water and let it cook for 7 to 8 minutes. Cover the vessel.
Till that time, we will start preparing with our wheat bran roti. I have showed you the prepared dough. It has been rested for 8 to 7 minutes. We will take small rolls from the dough like this. Make a round circle. We will have to use some dried wheat and let's make some gold chapattis like this. We will take some oil and apply it into our roti. We will fold it in a form of square like this. And again we are going to use the dry atta. Till that time we will heat the kadai on a medium flame so that it heats up. Now we are going to roll it.
Powder, 1/2 teaspoon of garam masala, and cook it for 2 to 3 minutes.
Now, as we see, that roti has been cooked. It has become a light brown color and we can put it on the plate.
Our sabzi is also ready. So we are going to add some roasted sesame seeds for garnishing.
Now it has been ready to serve.
So we'll serve it. So we garnished the sabzi with roasted sesame seeds
and it is now ready to eat.